Hiromishima of Department of Human Genetics, Nagasaki University. At first, I'd like to thank all the Biohackathon 2008 to 2017 organizers. I was the local organizer of Biohackathon in Nagasaki, and I know the organizers' jobs are very hard. So I'd like to say thank you very much. Anyway, so at first I'd like to explain the AMED, AMED. AMED is the Japan Agency for Medical Research and Development. And, according to the AMED webpage, the providing a one-step service for research expenses AMED consolidated budget for research expenses, which had previously been allocated from different sources, three different ministries in Japan. Yep. Disclaimer: I'm not the man from AMED, so I'm sorry if I make mistaken explanation of the AMED's policy. AMED has a lot of grant programs, and I'm working for two different grant programs so far. One is a rare and intractable disease product of, project in Japan, and other is other programs including infrastructure of databases. First is IRAD. Initiative on rare and undiagnosed diseases. We call this IRUD, IRAD. So IRAD has two sub-projects. One is IRAD A, A for adult, adult and late onset diseases. And another one is IRAD P, P for pediatrics. The IRAD PISA project for children with undiagnosed diseases and their families. IRAD P has two central institutes, including National Center for Child Health and Development and Keio University in Tokyo. Nagasaki University is a regional institute of IRAD P. And there are several universities. And as I said 2 years ago, we have Biohackathon in Nagasaki. And in that Biohackathon in Nagasaki, some people of IRAD-P participated. And for example, Dr. Kosaki of Keio University and Dr. Groza, Chudo Groza, started new collaboration after this meeting. I think this is one of the biggest achievements of the Biohackathon in Nagasaki. So the policy of IRAD is published in European Journal of Human Genetics in 2017. This is not my paper, but it's including the president of AMED, Dr. Suemats. The title is IRAD Toward an End of the Diagnostic Odyssey. The odyssey means the big journey of children with Nambyo, or Nambyo is a literary translation is difficult diseases, rare and undiagnosed diseases, and their families to find their diagnosis. Helping this odyssey is our mission. So I said IRAD has several regional institutes. And each institute have different workflow, analysis workflows. Here, I'd like to introduce our cases. The samples are mainly family trials, and we have high-sex sequences, so we can perform exome sequencing. And after using GATK workflow and removing polymorphic site and synonymous variants using ANOVA and in-house scripts, we found de novo mutations, homozygote, compound heterozygote, and parental alleles, and list up the related genes and return such result to the clinician, a clinical geneticist. So parental alleles parental inherited alleles is I think it's interesting. Parental alleles means that sometimes each SNP or indels can be distinguished into maternal, inherited from father or inherited from father. It's a parental alleles. And after return such parental alleles and genes to clinical geneticist, this is my example of a conversation. This is a list of the maternal inherited variations and coding genes. And the clinician answers, the list has interesting genes. Patient and his or her mother share minor phenotype, which can be explained by the gene. Then I answer, hey, didn't you say the parents are unaffected? And this shows the difficulties in phenotyping. After getting the result of exome sequencing, the clinician's phenotype can be changed. So far, we analyzed about 140 family trials, about 420 individuals in Nagasaki University. Analyzed in Nagasaki University, patients and their families are mainly Kyushu Island, living in Kyushu Island. And only 30% of patients have been diagnosed, including patients with suspected diagnosis, the success rate is 40%. So the 60% of patients have not been diagnosed by current our workflow. This is the kind of so-called N of one problem. N of one problem is the paper, when we publish a gene is causal gene of some new syndrome, the reviewers, or not only reviewers, and other geneticists say they require the second patient even require description of second patient, even if the patient is only patient in the world. This is the N of one problem, and because of that, we have always found second patient sharing same genetic background. So one of the challenge to solve the problem in IRP project is IRP exchange. This is under development, so I'm sorry I can't show the screen capture, but the IRP Institute exchange is information sharing among Aida Institute across Japan. It's started by Dr. Kosaki, Keio University, and Dr. Chudo Broza. This system is based on the system written by Dr. Broza. In IRAT exchange, the IRAT exchange contains four information: anomalous patient ID and analysis center like Nagasaki University, and phenotypes in HPO, human phenotype ontology, and only candidate genes, gene symbols, not contains each variations and physical positions. And because the because of governmental guideline to protect patients' personal identification information, that's a kind of barrier. Another program in AMED is a program for integrated database for clinical and genomic information. In Japanese, we call RINGENO for shorter name. This program has sub programs. One of the program is program leader is Dr. Kosaki of Keio University. This is a screen capture of the phenotype of pathogenic variants. This is a kind of counterpart of NCBI's CRIMBA. This database contains each variation, including physical position, but not. This database does not contain the detailed phenotype. So the two databases, one has a deep phenotype, and deep or detailed phenotype. One is detailed genotypes. But so far, we do not combine two databases because of the privacy guidelines. This biohackathon, it was a session. Participants of this group is Fujiwara-san, Katayama-san, me, myself, and Ogishima-san, Yamamoto-san. We hope good discussion in this biohackathon. At the last, I show that my personal project in at biohackathon. My personal project is a rare and interesting pattern mining from human rare disease in literatures. And frequent pattern mining is a kind of Amazon's recommendation, the shopping bucket analysis. But I want to find rare and interesting pattern. Hypothesis papers whose abstracts have rare pattern of HPO words may be papers of rare disease. My idea is this can help to solve any of one problem by literature mining. This is Dr. Kim Jindon's pub annotation at DBCLS. This database contains a text data and their annotation. This is the PubMed HPO developed by Dr. Tudor-Rosa, contains PubMed abstracts and its annotation using HPO. I use these data as very good for my experiment. So summary, to overcome the N of one problem, so the aim is two databases database R&D project is working. One is IL2P, IL2 exchange, and another is database of pathogenic variants. And I'm doing by small my personal project to literature pattern mining. Thank you.